All right, here we go.
Obi-Wan play.
Everyone, this is my PlayStation 5 2020 Game Room Tour, and we're going to begin with the arcade cabinets. I'm a 90s kid. Well, I grew up in the 80s and 90s, and this is when arcades were at their pinnacle. And so three machines I had to have: Street Fighter 2, the granddaddy of fighting games, NBA Jam, the granddaddy of sports games, and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, one of my favorite side-scrolling beat-em-up type games. Had that on my NES and in the arcades. And so we have three one-up arcade cabinets. We also have another bonus one, Centipede, over in the corner. Since we're now over in the corner, let's look at the gaming closet. All right, and so we have a couple of Funko Pops. We have Ratchet and Clank, Kratos, Miles Morales, and Spider-Man. And if you notice the backdrop, we got a PlayStation theme backdrop. You know how we doing it. PS5 hype. Also, my Nintendo Power magazines. This is the very first issue of Nintendo Power and the very last issue. I was with Nintendo Power from the beginning all the way to the end until they discontinued the magazine. I was a gaming kid, bro. And so we got a couple of mini consoles. Shout out to Nintendo. They gave me that NES Classic for free. We also got the Xbox Elite controllers, the Elite 1, Elite 2. Those were my favorite controllers until the DualSense. We're gonna get to the PlayStation 5 stuff. We got a cubicle of just tons of Nintendo Switch stuff. We got games. Now, these are my digital games. Don't get it twisted. These are my physical games. Don't get it twisted. My digital collection, crazy on my Switch. We have four Switches, which you're about to see in a second. Smash, we got Pokeballs, we even got Mario cereals, you know what I'm saying? We got the Fight Stick, PlayStation 1 Classic Mini. This is the very first console I had as a kid, the Atari 7800. I still remember the commercial, 7800 from Atari. It was like a little corny rap, but I had this. My dad used to bring home bags of just cheap games from Atari, and this was backwards compatible with the 2600. So me and my older brother, we had tons of great memories on this. Pole Position, Pac-Man was trash on this. No, the 2600 version of Pac-Man, the 7800 version was lit. Miss Pac-Man. So it all started right here with the Atari 7800 for me. We also got the PlayStation Vita. Long live the Vita. I actually had both Vitas. I had the OG and the new one with updated screen. Bro, one of my favorite consoles of all time, the Sega Genesis. I had the old model, and this is the more updated model. I had a 32X and a Sega CD. I got that for Christmas. I don't have that on my channel, but I did get a Sega CD for Christmas. I remember playing Sewer Shark all Christmas Day. 32X was trash though. I only had like two good games. And then we have some Nintendo controllers. Bro, we have about 8 Pro controllers in this house. We got the, I forget the company that that did this one. This is a dope controller. Yeah, what y'all know about the Virtual Boy? I'm gonna show y'all the Virtual Boy in a second. We also got the Wave Bird controller. And so we got crazy amounts of Joy-Cons. We got, I have all the Pro controllers that, all the Pro controller models that came out on the Switch. We also got the Dreamcast. Hey, in college we used to play that Dreamcast. And some Super Nintendo games, Secret of Mana, some of the GOATs. We got Zelda. We got Mario All-Stars, Super Mario All-Stars. We got Super Metroid back there. We got all the Donkey Kong Country games. Super Nintendo, the GOAT of consoles. All right, let's keep going. All right, now I've showed this before. This is my Nintendo Wall of Fame. These are my favorite Nintendo consoles. For me, the GameCube was Nintendo's last great console when they went for power and tried to compete with first party and third party games. And we also have the Virtual Boy, all my Nintendo handheld consoles. This is the console that's special to me because this is when I really, really started gaming. The 7800 was cool, but the NES took it to another level. I got the power set for my birthday. The power pad, it had Duck Hunt, Track and Field, and Super Mario all in one cartridge. Where's the cartridge? It's all the way back there. We lit that end zapper. And the GOAT of consoles, still to this day, in my opinion, the greatest console of all time, the Super Nintendo. Nintendo had the best. I know some of y'all find this hard to believe, dudes that started gaming in the 3D era, but there was a time when Nintendo had the best looking first party and the best looking third party games all in one system, and this was it, the Super Nintendo. All right, we got that Kobe Bryant still sealed, Kobe Bryant courtside, RIP to one of the GOATs, Kobe Bryant courtside. And so this is my Nintendo Hall of Fame right above the arcade cabinets. Now let's look at the PlayStation 5. Wait, before we look at the PlayStation 5 stuff, above my closet, I do have boxes of some old consoles, some of the things that we just had collected all through the years. We are Apple family. We got iPads, MacBooks, Apple Watches, all that stuff. We got the PlayStation Classic, Nintendo, Super Nintendo Classic. These are the 4 Switch boxes. And we have 4 Switches somewhere in the house. I have a 1 TB Switch somewhere here too. That Wii U, Splatoon 2, Xbox One X, PS4 Pro, the God of War Edition. We had the Labo kits for the kids. The kids love the Labo stuff. And that Kinect, boy, what y'all know about the Kinect. Now, for real, let's do the PlayStation 5, the heart of the Game Room Tour. All right, so this is where the magic happens, where I record, where I stream. We got a 3 monitor set up. When I'm doing my gaming streams, this is what I play on, my 4K monitor. You know that 2K is right there. I've been on Call of Duty lately. I am almost through Demon Souls. So this is actually my kid's PS5. Their setup is actually in another room, but just to flex for this video, I put both PS5s in the same room, but this one isn't connected because it belongs in another room. We got the Obi-Wan Plays hats, you know what I'm saying? Ah, major luck. All right, oh, also over here, this is my 8 TB external hard drive. I'm not connecting this to my PS5 because of all the glitches and systems crashing, so I haven't yet. All right, so we have the DualSense controllers, the GOAT of controllers. I talked about how the Super Nintendo, greatest console of all time. For me right now, the second best console of all time is the PlayStation 4. Great first party and third party games. Let's see if the PS5 can live up to it. So these three controllers are for my kids. I got them their own controllers. They have their initials on the back so they know whose own is whose. The charge dock, the media remote, boy. And we have the PS5 3D Pulse headset. It's a dope headset, lightweight. The only thing, the mic is trash. The audio is good that you hear, but when you output, the mic isn't that good. Speaking of mic, we just bought this mic. Jury is still out on this mic that I just bought. I might upgrade to an even better one. All right, we have my wife. Shout out to the wife, and she bought me this PlayStation mug. And you know, we already got, you know what I'm saying, free advertising for the Obi-Wan Plays merch. The coasters underneath, fun fact, my kids made those coasters, so they're in the game room. The kids made it. And these are my two controllers, my two DualSense controllers. I switch them out once one battery runs low, put them in the dock, and I start gaming on the other one. And above, my setup is the wall, the PlayStation 5 wall. We got the box for both control on both consoles. We have all the accessories, and the pinnacle of the entire game room is the media remote. Put respect on the media remote name, boy. All right, and so short, really not too extravagant or whatnot, but this is my 2020 game room setup since the PlayStation 5 has arrived. I hope you guys enjoyed it. What do you guys think about my setup? Wait, I'm not done yet. One more thing in the corner. Some of the merch. We have the hype hat. We have the shirts in the corner. Fun fact, for those of you who are in my live stream, when I was buying my PS5. Now, I'm not hyped for Cyberpunk, so I didn't even buy the game, but for being first in line for the PS5 to purchase the PS5 at my GameStop, they gave me the Cyberpunk shirt. So that's the only reason why I have this shirt in my game room, because it reminds me that I was first in line for the PS5. And if those who were watching that live stream, y'all know why I got that shirt. And last but not least, we got the Jamaica bag. Big up Jamaica. That's where I was born, you know what I'm saying? We live in Florida now, but that's it, man. That's the game room tour. Hope you guys liked it. We're always making adjustments, improvements for every year, man. So stay tuned for a 2021 game room tour if I add anything new that I think needs to be added. Oh, and of course, we have the PC underneath. We got wires and stuff. And the chair with the signature Obi-Wan Plays chair. With the J's, my favorite shoes of all time, those 11 breads. All right, man, we out. I'll see y'all later. Deuces.
You still watching this video? That means you like me. You really like me. I gotta hook you up. That's right. I'm giving away a $60 digital code every month for your platform of choice. Xbox, Nintendo, or PlayStation. Two ways to enter. One, make sure you're subscribed to this fire right here on YouTube. Two, follow me on Twitter at Obi-Wan Plays. And that's it. You're in for the giveaway. But wait, there's more. Do you want to join an awesome gaming Discord with prizes and tournaments? Do you want to get on my friend list and game with your boy? Become a sponsor. Three ways to join. One, subscribe on Twitch. If you have Twitch Prime, you can do it for free. Two, click the join button right here on YouTube and become a member. And the third way to join, patreon.com/Obi-Wan Plays. You'll thank me later. Also, check out the swag, bro. Links are in the description. I'll see you later. Deuces.